Might sound like a good idea.
But it also can be dangerous in this really extreme heat. Valerie Bragg is live now at a playground with a warning for you tonight.
Mark and Noreen, it's so hot out here just standing here, but trust me, this playground equipment is a lot warmer. And if you do decide to bring your kids out here, keep in mind that these metal pieces are a lot hotter than the plastic ones. Amber and Alex come to Blue Park almost every day. While they burn some of their energy, Mom Allison Cook is always making sure that's the only thing that's burning.
I'd rather go first and then have them go, so. Because sometimes she'll be like, it's hot.
And it is.
148 degrees on the balance beam.
Park maintenance director Randy Brown says it only takes seconds for children to burn on anything over 140 degrees.
142 degrees. On this.
But children's skin can still burn even when it is slightly cooler.
Anything over 120 degrees can begin to cause burns depending on the exposure. So you don't want them sitting on hot surfaces for too long.
Of course, most of us don't have a heat gun ready to bring to the playground. But parents, you're still urged to check the equipment before letting your children play on it.
I would lay the back of your hand is sensitive, but it's not going to burn as easily. So you want to lay some more tender skin on it. So I would just do that. If that's too hot to the back of your arm, it's probably going to be too hot for your child's tender skin.
For Amber and Alex, they haven't been burned yet, and their mom plans to keep it that way.
We like to come when it's cool, like in the mornings and cool in the evenings. But if it's, you know, later, like in the midday, we still take precautions.
Now, Parks and Recs also recommends keeping your shoes on when playing in the park. Earlier this morning, mulch temperatures were measuring nearly 150 degrees, and no one wants burned feet. Reporting live from Chatham Middle School, Valerie Bragg, ABC 13 News.
No, you don't.